Good evening. Somebody knows something but is not saying a word. And investigators hope that these orange bulbs will help. At the highest levels, this investigation is still top of mind. One family has spent the last few days mailing out flyers with the suspect's picture to people across the country. 1,000 so far. As friends and strangers light their bulbs and remain alert for that wanted man.
You couldn't find an orange light bulb anywhere around.
Paulette Ferguson changed that, shedding light on a plea to find the man accused of killing Abby Williams and Libby German. She's the lady behind thousands of orange bulbs that will remain lit until an arrest is made.
I pray for the day we can just turn off our orange light bulbs and I don't have a party, throw them at something, or just to know that that monster is away and not ever going to do that again.
Soon after the Delphi investigation began on February 14th, Libby's mom began the orange bulb movement, drawing the attention of Paulette, who wanted to help. She emailed several companies. One company was willing to ship them, and she could sell them for $1. Another company, Westinghouse, agreed to send a semi with a surprising 2,500 bulbs. The only requirement, she could not sell them.
A lot of them are like, well, how much are they? And I said, they're free, and they looked at you like, no way.
Now people in Lafayette, Monticello, Buffalo, Delphi, and towns and cities in between illuminate their homes in orange.
When I see them all lit up, it's just, sometimes it's overwhelming. Living in a small town, you just never think anything like that would happen.
A bright gesture, marking a dark moment in time.
Paulette says if any of her orange bulbs burn out, she will have to go buy new ones. Why is that? Because she got so wrapped up, Erica, in passing them out that she did not keep any for her home. So if it happens, she's ready to go out to go shopping. Her focus, of course, was to make sure that light bright shinily throughout Indiana.
So many people want to know what's the latest on this investigation.
So this investigation is like an archaeological dig. Police have so many different pieces, but they're looking still for that one tip to put it all together. Of course, the key tips is this voice and the picture you're about to see. Down the hill, down the hill, down the hill. That was the recording of the suspect. And of course, there's that sketch. If you know that person, you're asked to call right now the FBI tip line, 844-459-5786. And Eric, I wanted to show you, just got a picture of the flyers that the family of Libby German are mailing out to people across the country. They've already mailed out 120 packets to date. They plan to keep on mailing as long as they need to. They're also going to create a map to show exactly where all the different flyers are going.
All right, keep us posted on the latest, Raphael. Thank you.